Yahtzee!
What?
Let's do this.
진짜 다른 세계에서 왔어?
Oh my god.
Hi everyone. Welcome to another episode of Get Real, the Work From Home Edition. Now, these unprecedented circumstances that we find ourselves in only serves to underline how crucial streaming has become to our daily lives. So, for this episode, I'm going to be giving you a rundown of what is interesting to stream for this month. So, I'm Andrew Paredes. Let's get real and let's talk what's streaming for the month of April 2020. Now, if you're a fan of the outlandish and whimsical comedy that was Community, then you're in for some good news because Netflix is dropping all 6 seasons of this beloved comedy. Now, if you're a fan of these offbeat characters who find themselves in whimsical situations at this community college where everybody is really just looking for a second chance, then I suggest that you relive Community in all its weird glory starting April 1. And if you haven't discovered Community, then now's your chance to discover what this cult comedy was all about.
You enjoy, I have to leave early.
Oh?
I've got an invite to the opening of a new club.
I made that in Photoshop and mailed it to you a month ago so that you keep tonight open on your calendar.
There's no such thing as single malt platinum boobs and billiards club?
Amazon Prime is not really much in a league with Netflix in terms of how much content it makes available practically every week. But the original content that it does load has proven to be very, very interesting and in most cases award-winning. The Marvelous Mrs. Maisel and Modern Love have all come to us courtesy of Amazon Prime. And with that track record, I would recommend taking a look at the very intriguing Tales from the Loop. Now, not much is known about this very, very intriguing Amazon series, which until now is being shrouded in mystery. All I can tell you is that it seems to be following a group of people who live on top of a contraption called the Loop, which is a machine that allows them to access the mysteries and contradictions of the universe. Now, if that isn't mind-bending enough for you, the cast roster might entice you to check it out. The cast includes such names as Rebecca Hall and Jonathan Pryce. And if that isn't enough, then Amazon Prime's track record for giving you award-winning content should seal the deal. If you haven't checked out the Spanish streaming series Money Heist, I suggest you do now because there are 3 seasons currently available to stream and the 4th season will start streaming also on April 3 in Netflix. Now, Money Heist follows this gang of thieves who plan to relieve the Spanish mint of 2.4 billion euros. As it so happens in heist movies, there are a lot of twists and double crosses along the way. So I suggest that you bone up on Money Heist's 3 seasons before the 4th season starts streaming on April 3. As if April 3 wasn't busy enough, you also have the option to stream the comedy Coffee and Kareem, which stars Ed Helms as this nondescript traffic cop who is in a relationship with Empire's Taraji P. Henson, much to the chagrin of her 12-year-old son, who then hires a hitman to scare his potential stepfather, Ed Helms, out of the house. It looks pretty funny, and if it isn't funny, well, it's just an hour and a half of your life away from you, but it does look promising. So Coffee and Kareem, also on April 3, also on Netflix.
Is everything okay?
This all started when your son tried to have me killed because he saw us having sex this morning.
It's not safe here.
Oh, what an idea, date a white guy.
Now, jumping ahead to the end of the month, you will find The Willoughbys, which is an animated feature streaming on Netflix starting on April 22. It's based on one of those subversive children's books about a group of kids who scheme to have their parents shipped away on vacation because, based on the trailer, they seem to be selfish and neglectful parents, only to have themselves pursued by a sinister child welfare-like agency. And these kids have to elude these grown-ups who are intent on catching them because they are without parents. And all they can rely on is the help of a nanny. Now, the cast includes Will Forte, Jane Krasinski of 30 Rock, and Maya Rudolph. And on top of that top caliber talent, the animation looks spectacular.
Hello!
Danger, danger!
I am your nanny! I cook, clean, sing!
What? You sing?
Yeah!
Now, if you're a fan of documentaries, why not try a documentary with a hint of humor to it? If that sounds like your cup of tea, then I have the recommendation for you. Streaming on April 22, again on Netflix, is Absurd Planet, which takes a look at the funniest looking creatures that we have on planet Earth. As far as I'm concerned, Absurd Planet had me at funny documentary. So go check it out when it starts streaming on April 22, also on Netflix.
Ever notice how the most normal-looking critters are always secretly the biggest freaks? The pearlfish wants to live inside the sea cucumber's rectum.
Now, if you find yourself in Avengers withdrawal, then why not go for the next best thing, which is Extraction, which starts streaming on Netflix on April 24. Extraction features Chris Hemsworth. Chris Hemsworth is back in fighting form as a Black Ops mercenary who is hired by a crime kingpin who is in prison to save his kidnapped child. So, sounds pretty action-packed.
Are you always this brave?
I'm not brave.
You rescue people?
Sometimes.
And as if that wasn't enough, you also have the option to log on to Apple TV Plus. Go check out Defending Jacob. Now, Defending Jacob stars the other Chris of the Avengers, Chris Evans, who plays a father who has to defend his child, played by his Knives Out co-star Jaden Martell, who has been accused of murdering a classmate. Defending Jacob is shaping up to be drama with gravitas. Now, the first three episodes of Defending Jacob will be available to stream via Apple TV Plus starting April 24. And finally, you didn't think I would let this episode pass without a K-drama, right? Your K-drama fix for this month will come from Netflix via The King, Eternal Monarch. Premise is about this king from the past who is tasked with closing the doorway between dimensions, and aiding him in this task is, I presume, a pretty detective. Now, really, the biggest recommendation that The King, Eternal Monarch has going for it is that it stems from the brain trust behind Goblin. And Goblin just happens to be one of the most beloved K-dramas of all time. I'm very excited to see it. I hope that it surpasses the expectations that Goblin has set for it. If you have a Netflix subscription, I'm sure that Netflix will not be remiss in telling you when it finally drops. So, your K-drama fix for the month of April, The King, Eternal Monarch.
당신은 마치 날 아는 사람처럼 굴는데 난 당신 몰라.
내가 여기 없듯 자네도 내 세계에는 없었어.
난 아직 지구가 둥글다는 것도 안 믿기는 사람이야.
And this has been your streaming guardian, Andrew Paredes. So thank you for getting real with me.